kids. We did a lot of addition last month. Now, let us do the exact opposite of addition. What is the opposite of addition? Yes, subtraction. For example, you already have few keychains. When you get few more, what happens? That is addition. If you give some of it or if you lose it, it is subtraction. When you learn something new, what does your brain say? Wow, you're adding a lot of information. You are adding a lot of information. When you forget something, what does your brain say? It says you're subtracting. You're removing a lot of information. So, subtraction is nothing but removing, taking away. So, you are very well versed with subtraction already. But I'll just give you an introduction. To start off, how did we do subtraction? For example, 8 minus 3, and you all know the symbol of subtraction, minus, that is the minus symbol. So, what is 8 minus 3? To start off, we did the crossing out method. We drew any object, we'll draw an ice cream. Okay, so we'll draw 8 ice creams, and minus is crossing out or removal. So, can we cross 3 ice creams? 1, 2, 3. And then you would simply count and find how many ice creams are there. How many ice creams are left out? 5. So, 8 minus 3 is 5. This is something we all know very well. Kids, to move to bigger numbers, this poem will help us. This subtraction poem. We've already learnt it, but keep repeating it again and again so that you don't forget. Okay, more on top, no need to stop. More on the floor, go next door and get 10 more. Numbers the same, zeros the game. So, I'll tell you how to use that poem with an example. Here we have to do 25 minus 12. We'll have to subtract the smaller number 12 from the bigger number 25. First, let us find what is top, what is floor. Obviously, the number on top is top. The number on bottom is the floor. So, we'll have to find next which is more. More on top or more on floor. Kids, remember, here you have to look at the number in the ones place first. Be it addition or subtraction, we always start with the digit in the ones place, then tens, then hundreds and so on. So, here can you find 5 is on top, 2 is on the floor. Which is more? Yes, 5 is bigger than 2, so there is more on top. So, what would you do? More on top? No need to stop. So, let's not stop, kids. Let's do subtraction. We'll do it with the help of beads. In the ones place, we'll have 5 beads. And in the tens place, we'll have 2 chains. So, here we have 25. We have shown the number on the top, the bigger number. Now, to do subtraction, we have to cross out the number on the bottom. So, in the ones place, what number is there? 2. So, let's subtract 2 from 5. We'll use the cross out method. Cross, cross. Yes, 2 times we've crossed. So, what is left out? 3. So, we'll write 3 down. In the tens place, what number is there? 1. So, we have to subtract 1. We'll cross 1 chain. So, what is left out, kids? Only 1 is left out. So, you'll write 1. So, 25 minus 12 is 13. More on top, no need to stop. Was very simple, right? So, in the next session, I'll teach you how to use the rest of the poem. Bye, kids.